Good morning, children. How are you all? Welcome back to our social science class. Do you remember me? I am Asha, your social science teacher. Today, we are going to continue the second chapter of TN2 textbook. Do you remember the name of the second chapter? So, it is the second chapter of TN2 textbook, and the name of our chapter is Water Wealth. Water Wealth and Agriculture. So what is the name of our chapter? Water Wealth and Agriculture. In the previous class, Savita teacher taught you up to multi-purpose dams. Right, children? So today we are continue that chapter. Are you ready? Let's begin the class. So we are going to study at first about water conservation. What do you mean by water conservation? We want to conserve the water. Why we want to conserve the water? Because water is so precious. Our earth is called a blue planet because of the presence of water. But from that water, only a small percentage of water is fresh water. And from that fresh water, only a small percentage of water is accessible to us. That's why it is so precious. We want to conserve the water. It is a natural resource. Clear, children? So in your textbook, four simple measures are mentioned in your textbook. So you want to study that four simple measures. Clear, children? So let us revise that points. First one, avoid leakage of water from taps. Avoid leakage of water from taps. If the water is spoiling like this, is it correct? No. We want to avoid the leakage of taps. One drop of water is so precious. So many countries are facing the scarcity of water. Even if in India, we are facing the scarcity of water. When we are thinking about Kerala, some of the villages are also facing scarcity of water. For example, Kasaragod, then some rural areas of Kasaragod and some villages of Alappi are also facing the scarcity of water. That's why we want to conserve the water. Avoid leakage of water from taps. We want to repair the taps if it is leaking. Clear, children? Next is close taps after use. You all know that after the use, we want to close the taps. Clear? I know you are good children, so you will do this. Right. And the third point is store rainwater for household use. Store rainwater for household use. Can you see this picture? Here, the rainwater. This is the rainwater. The rainwater is stored in this tank. So, we want to store the rainwater for later use. If there is no tank, don't worry. You can collect the rainwater in buckets and bottles. And we can reuse that for watering plants, washing clothes and utensils, etc. Clear? So, the third point is store rainwater for household use. Clear? And the fourth point is, this is the most important point. Do not pollute water. Do not pollute water. How the water is polluted? Do you want to show? Do you want to see how the water is polluted? So I am going to show you a video. Let's watch. Okay. So this man is throwing waste into the river, and also a lady is throwing waste into the river. Can you see this? So this pollutes the water. Is it right? No, right? And these people are washing clothes, utensils and animals in the water. That also pollute the water. And most of our factories emit the waste water into the rivers. That also pollute the water. So these all causes water pollution. We should not do that. We want to conserve the water. Why I am saying this to you? You are the next generation and you want to take care of our earth. If we want to use this water in future, we want to conserve that. Right, children? So, there are four measures written in your textbook. You want to study that. Which are they? avoid leakage of water from taps. Close taps after use. Store rainwater for household use. Then do not pollute water. These are the four steps. In your textbook, the last point is written in another way. But you want to write as it is shown because you want to write like this. Do not pollute water. Clear? So four points are there. Avoid the leakage of taps. Then do not pop. So close the taps after use. And the third one, collect rainwater for household users. And the fourth one is do not pollute water. Underline that and write it. Okay, and study that. Okay, children. So this may be asked as your 2 or 3 mark question in your term exam. Clear? Now we are moving on to agriculture. This is the next topic, agriculture. Can you see this picture? The people are engaged in different activities related to agriculture. Clear? Agriculture is the main occupation of India. Agriculture is the main occupation of India. Why it is considered as the main occupation? Do you know, children? Around 70% of people are practicing agriculture in India. What is this 70% calculation? If we are considering 100 people, from that 100 people, 70 people are practicing agriculture. If it is 1,000, then 700 people are practicing agriculture. If it is 10,000, then 7,000 people are practicing agriculture. Like the same way, in India, around 121 crore people are there. Around 121 crore people are there. From that people, 70% of people are practicing agriculture. That means most of the people are practicing agriculture. That's why it is considered as the main occupation of India. Agriculture is the main occupation of India. Clear? Okay. And also it can be said as the backbone of Indian economy. Agriculture can be said as the backbone of Indian economy. Clear? We are cultivating different types of crops in India. According to the climatic conditions, availability of water, we are cultivating different crops in different areas. Clear, children? So now we are going to discuss about the types of crops. In India, the crops are mainly divided into two. They are food crops and cash crops. Food crops and cash crops. Clear? This is food crops and the next type is cash crops. From its name itself, you will know that what is it meant for. Food crops are the crops which are grown for food. Food crops are the crops which are grown for food. And the cash crops are grown for earning money. Cash crops are grown for earning money. Clear? So there are two types of crops, food crops and cash crops. Food crops are grown for food and cash crops are grown for earning money. This is not, we are not using cash crops as directly as food item. Indirectly we are using. Okay, I'll tell you in later slide. When see the later slide, I'll explain that. Okay, we are using cash crops for earning money. We are exporting these cash crops into different countries and thus we will get the money. So main types of crops are food crops and cash crops. Clear, children? You want to underline that, the types of crops. You want to write the difference between food crops and cash crops. This is your another question in the note. Clear? Now we are going to learn the examples for food crops. Food crops are mainly grown for food, right? So this is the first one, rice. This is a rice plant. From this rice plant, we get the rice. So this is the rice plant. From this rice plant, we get the rice. Rice is the staple food of India. Especially the South Indians eat rice as their staple food. Next is pulses. Next is pulses. There are different types of pulses, such as different varieties of grams are there, different varieties of dals are there, different varieties of grams such as black gram, green gram, etc. And dal varieties such as tur dal, masoor dal, etc. All these are considered as pulses. Pulses are also a major food crop in India. Clear? The next is wheat. This is wheat plant. From this wheat plant, we are getting this wheat. Wheat is also the staple food of India. Especially the North Indians eat wheat more. Is it clear? Then next is millets. Millets are small seeds. For example, ragi. Have you heard about ragi? Kuvaragu. Ketutonda? So that type of small seeds are known as what? Millets. Millets are rich with iron content. Clear? So these all are examples for food crops. If it is asked, if the question is asked like name any four food crops, you want to write these examples. Which are they? Rice, pulses, wheat, millets. These are the four examples for food crops. Which are they? Rice, pulses, wheat and millets. Clear children? Next is cash crop. Cash crops are grown for earning money. Right children? So I told you that we are not eating the cash crops directly, but indirectly we are considered it as food. Right? So first one is sugar cane. From sugar cane we are making sugar. From sugar cane we are making sugar. You want to underline that point that is written in your textbook. Clear? So sugar cane. From sugar cane, we are making sugar. So, we are indirectly using this. Right, children? Next is, next cash crop is cotton. What is it? Cotton. We are making clothes from cotton. Cotton is a cash crop. And it is known as king of fibers. It is known as king of fibers. Cotton is known as king of fibers. Underline that, okay? You want to study that sentence. King of fiber is cotton. Clear? Then the next cash crop is jute. Jute is another cash crop. This is jute plant. From this jute plant, we are getting this jute yarns. Clear? We are making clothes, bags, etc. from this jute yarn. And its color looks like golden, right? That's why it is known as golden fiber. Underline that sentence, okay? Golden fiber. Jute is also known as golden fiber. It is also a cash crop. Clear? Next is tea. Every day our morning starts with a hot tea or coffee, right? So tea is also a cash crop. Clear? So from this topic you want to underline the sentence. Cotton is also known as king of fiber and jute is also known as what? Golden fiber. Then sugar cane. Sugar is extracted from sugar cane. You want to underline that three sentences. Okay. Next cash crop is coffee. From this coffee beans, we are making coffee powder. And the smell is so awesome. Right, children? Next is spices. Do you know, children, which state is known as the spice garden of India? Our Kerala is known as the spice garden of India. It is written in your textbook. You want to underline that. Okay. Spice garden of India, Kerala. Spices are also a cash crop. Next is oil seeds. We are using different types of seeds to make oils. For example, coconut. From coconut, we are making coconut oil. From mustard, we are making mustard oil, etc. Clear? So, oil seeds are also examples for cash crop. From this topic, that means the different types of crops are written in your text, mentioned in your textbook in detail. No need to study that whole sentences. Only the sentences I asked you to underline, want to study. Clear, children? Only that all asked for the exam. Clear? No need to study all the sentences which were mentioned in the textbook. Only the sentences which I told you to underline, you want to study. From this topic, you want to study the two crops, two types of crops, then examples for any four examples for these two types of crops, and then next topic. Okay, I hope all of you understood this topic. We are moving on to the next. Next is green revolution. This is a new term you are studying. Green revolution. It is also known as agricultural revolution. What is it? Agricultural revolution. When we see the farms, we can see it in green color, right? So that's why it is known as green revolution. As it is seen in green color, we called it as green revolution. Clear, children? Then what is agricultural revolution? It is the increase in food production. It is the increase in food production. For the increase in food production, the government used some measures. Which are the measures? They used better quality of seeds. They used better quality of seeds, better fertilizers, better fertilizers. Valangal ubayogichu dharalam pudhiya reethiyilullathu. Next, modern methods of cultivation. They began to use modern methods of cultivation. Here some pictures are here. These are the fertilizers used by whom? The government for agricultural increase, right? And these are the more modern techniques used by the government. In olden days, we done all the agricultural things as manually, but now we are using modern types of methods. For example, this is a harvesting machine. With this harvesting machine, this is a harvesting machine. Harvesting machine. By this harvesting machine, we can harvest the crops within a short span of time. And this is a with this machine, they are chilling the soil. In olden days, we used wooden plow, and now it is used these types of machines for tilling the soil. So by using these machines, we can do it in a short span of time. Clear, children? So what is green revolution? Green revolution refers to the increase in food production. It refers to the increase in food production. ഇതുവരെ കേട്ടിട്ടുള്ളതോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കണ്ടിട്ടുള്ളതിൽ നിന്നോ വ്യത്യസ്തമായി വളരെ വർധനയിലുള്ള ഫുഡ് പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ. ഓക്കെ, സോ ഇൻക്രീസ് ഇൻ ഫുഡ് പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ ത്രൂ ബെറ്റർ ക്വാളിറ്റി സീഡ്സ്, ബെറ്റർ ഫെർട്ടിലൈസേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് മോഡേൺ മെത്തേഡ്സ് ഓഫ് കൾട്ടിവേഷൻ. ദീസ് ആർ ദ ത്രീ മെഷേഴ്സ് ടേക്കൺ ബൈ ദ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ടു ഇൻക്രീസ് ഫുഡ് പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ. ക്ലിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ? ക്ലിയർ? സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ ടോപ്പിക്സ് വി വോണ്ട് ടു സ്റ്റഡി ടുഡേ. വാട്ട് വി സ്റ്റഡി ടുഡേ? We studied about conservation of water. From that topic, you want to study the four measures for water conservation, right? Then we studied about agriculture. Agriculture is the main occupation of India, and 70% of people are practicing agriculture in India, and it is the backbone of our Indian economy. Then we studied about the two types of cultivation, the two types of crops. Which are they? Food crops and cash crops. You want to study the difference between food crops and cash crops. Clear? Then we studied about the examples for food crops and cash crops. You want to study any four examples for food crops and any four examples for cash crops. Clear? Then we studied about green revolution. Green revolution means it is the increase in food production. You want to study that sentence. Okay, how we increased the food production? We used certain measures. Which are the measures? Better quality seeds, better fertilizers and modern methods of cultivation. You want to study this. Now we are going to do some exercises. That all exercises you want to study, because that questions will be asked for your TAME exam. Clear, children? Only these topics what I studied today, and also you want to study the notes sent by the teacher. You want to study that things only. Okay, now we are going to do some exercises. First question: to conserve water, we should avoid dash. To conserve water, we should avoid dash. Options are leakage of water from taps, using water, using buckets. Which is the correct answer? To conserve water, we should avoid leakage of water from taps. It is the first measure we studied at first, right? So to conserve water, we should avoid leakage of water from taps. Clear, children? Next, sugar is produced from what? Sugar is produced from dash. Jaggery, honey, sugarcane, potatoes. Jaggery, honey, sugarcane, potatoes. Is the sugar is produced from potatoes? No. Then which is the correct answer? Yes, it is sugarcane. Sugar is produced from sugarcane. S-U-G-A-R-C-A-N-E. Sugarcane. Clear? Next question. Dash is known as the king of fibers. Dash is known as the king of fibers. Jute, wool, nylon, cotton. Which is the correct answer? Jute, wool, nylon, cotton. Which is the correct answer? Yes, it is cotton. Cotton is known as the king of fibers. Clear? Then the fourth question. Dash is also known as the golden fiber. Dash is also known as the golden fiber. Think about the color of that fiber. Okay. Cotton, jute, nylon, silk. Is it cotton? What is the color of cotton? White. So that is not the answer. Then which is the correct answer? Yes, jute is the answer. J-U-T-E. Jute is the correct answer. Jute is also known as the golden fiber. Clear? Now, next question. Spice Garden of India. Spice Garden of India. Options are Maharashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Which is the correct answer? Is it Tamil Nadu? No. Spice Garden of India is our God's own country, Kerala. Our God's own country, Kerala. Clear, children? The Green Revolution led to an increase in dash. The Green Revolution led to an increase in dash. Options are plant production, milk production, food production and spice production. Which is the correct answer? It is the increase in food production. Clear? It is the increase in food production. So, the Green Revolution led to an increase in food production. Dash is a food crop. Dash is a food crop. Sugarcane, jute, cotton, oil seeds, rice. Is sugarcane is a food crop? No. Then is it as cotton? No. Then which is the correct answer? It is rice. Rice is a food crop. Clear, children? Rice is a food crop. Then eighth one, dash is a cash crop. Dash is a cash crop. Which is a cash crop? Rice, coffee, wheat, pulses. Is it pulses? No. Then which is the correct answer? It is coffee. Coffee is a cash crop. Is it clear? So these are the exercise. All these exercise want to study because these may be asked as your one mark question in the first step. Clear, children? So you want to study from this topic. You want to study the four steps of water conservation, the two types of crops. You want to study the difference between two types of crops. Then the examples for food crop and cash crop. Then you want to study the important sentences which I told you to underline. Then you want to study these exercises. Also, you want to study about Green Revolution. Clear? So, hope all of you understood what I taught today. We are winding up this topic. We will meet again with another topic. Until then, stay safe and stay healthy. Okay? Thank you. And one more thing, if there is any doubt regarding this topic, you can call me. My phone number is given here. Anytime you can call me, I'll clear your doubts. Okay, bye.